TSBVI Outreach Tutorial. The Orion TI-36X Talking Scientific Calculator, Part 1, Accessories. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant for Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach. Experience, Master of Education, Certified Teacher of the Visually Impaired and Secondary Mathematics, and 30-plus years as a classroom teacher at TSBVI in Secondary Mathematics.
Today we're going to take a look at the Orion TI-36X Talking Scientific Calculator. And I'm going to show you exactly how it arrives at your doorstep. You would purchase it either from Orbit Research or another vendor who is selling it for them. Orbit Research is the manufacturer. But APH does sell the item. It's not, let me point out, not on federal quota monies, but APH does sell the Orion TI-36X Talking Scientific Calculator. So if you happen to purchase it from them, it will come in a box like this. So I'm just going to kind of go through the procedure. So when you get your box, which I'm going to kind of put it to the side and then just reach in and see what the first thing up is. We get this little box, and this is going to contain your charger. Very important. This is what you're going to have to charge your battery with. And once you get the Orion out, you're going to have to plug it in, and it needs to be charged for 16 hours. Very important. First thing you do is plug it in and get it charged up and leave it be. And after that 16 hours, then you can go ahead and start using it. And what I always tell my students is, as soon as I hear low battery, I tell them, hand it over, and we put it on the charger and say it's got to get its rest, get recharged. So very important, be sure that you do have this charger inside your box and hold on to it, and be very careful, because there's always a concern, do I have the right charger that goes with my calculator? Okay, so that's the first thing that I just grabbed out of the box. That's in there, and very important. In addition, you have what I'm going to just call an earphone. I think I'll go ahead and open this up. It's going to be for one ear. It's just going to fit over the one ear, left, or in this case, looks like it's left ear. And it has a tiny little, let's take a peek at that. It just has one of those, I think, I'm just going to say it's one of those type of plugs for something that is not stereophonic. It's just got the. It's only going to go on the one ear, and it's much skinnier. And let's just say, while I've got this out, if you decide, or your student decides, that this is not for them, that they prefer their stereo headphones that they use for everything else, that would be fine. Except this particular the normal stereophones headphones do not have this particular outlet. What they have, if you're going to use those, is they're going to need something like this. And what you're going to notice here, I just call this an adapter, and I'm sure it has a much higher technical name. But if you look at these two in comparison, these are the same size, and either one of these will go into your calculator. But if you have the stereo headphones, you're going to have to first plug them into this. And that way, if you plug that, you will be able to plug in the stereo headphones into this, and then this goes into the calculator. So again, you can choose the earphone mono that comes in with the calculator, or if you're a student or you want to use the stereo headphones, you're going to have to get yourself an adapter that looks something like this, that will take the larger plug and transform it into the smaller one that goes into your calculator. So keep that in mind. I always worry that this is going to get lost. I usually put it in a little Ziploc bag that's bigger than it, so hopefully I won't go off and lose that. This does not come with your calculator. So if you need this, you're going to have to go out and purchase one of these on your own. Okay, so we've looked at the ear piece that comes with it. In addition, you are going to find, oh my gosh, we still have one of these 3.5 floppies that's going to have, let me turn it this way too so I can read what it says. And it does say it's from Orbit Research, and it is a user's manual on a 3.5 floppy disk. They even have it on one of these. I don't even know if y'all have one of these little older discs, so you can play it on this as well if you have that. I'm not even sure what you call that kind of a thing anymore. I haven't seen one of these for a while. I guess that's what they call a cassette player. And I'm going to actually take the calculator itself out, but I think in the very bottom, I'm going to show you what I usually tend to use, which is the manual in print format. And like I said, these two are in there, but this is probably the one that's going to be the most valuable to someone with vision, probably for the math teacher or the VI teacher. And here you've got your, I don't know if it's large print, but it's certainly good-sized print, and it gives you all kinds of directions on how to use the Orion TI-36X.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, Orion Calculator. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on math for the blind and visually impaired. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone, 512-454-8631. Website, www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2010. All rights reserved.